Shalom. First and foremost, all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors the apostles. See, I'll take street brothers doing this thing sincerely, truth, and with charity. Right, man, we're going to hop right into it. Joel, second chapter, start with the first verse. Brothers, whatever precepts come in mind, just bring them out.
You said Joel 2 and 1? This is Joel 2, the first verse. Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of Yahweh cometh, for it is nigh at hand.
Right, so this is a book, or this chapter, it's about to go into the prophecies of the end. Alright, this is basically going to give you signs of the times. Okay, and what's to come? Go ahead, Shalom.
Because it says,
for
the day of the Lord is at hand. Can a brother grab Amos? Shall I grab Amos and, verse 18?
Talk about what?
Amos 5 and 18.
This is Amos 5 and 18.
You find that scripture that says, hasten.
Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord. To what end is it for you?
Right. You know, so this day that's coming, you know what I'm saying? In Amos, you know, the Lord just said, woe unto you that desire that day. You know? So now we finna find the, Lord willing, the other scripture where the Lord tells his servants to hasten that day. You know? And can you find that in Wisdom of Solomon not? With the salvation comes the destruction of the enemies.
Okay.
You know? Because the Lord is coming with that balance. Because the day of the Lord is not only coming with destruction, but it's also coming with salvation. You know? So woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord. You know? Because you haven't been walking in his ways. You haven't been walking in Yahweh Shai. You didn't have that faith in Yahweh Shai. But the ones that he tell to hasten that day, you know, the ones that's going to receive salvation, which comes that balance, you know? Did you find it, bro?
I'll finish off the scripture.
Yeah, go ahead, bro.
The day of the Lord is darkness and not light.
Right, man. You know? That day is gloomy. Matter of fact, what a brother looking for, Joel 2 and 2, says a day of darkness and of gloominess. Can you read that last verse you just read, bro?
Amos 5 and 18. Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord. To what end is it for you? The day of the Lord is darkness and not light.
Mm-hmm. It's darkness and not light. So which this verse 2 says, a day of darkness and of gloominess. You know, so that's going to be a horrible, terrible day. A day of clouds and of thick darkness. You know, and that's, well, it says, as the morning spread upon the mountains. You know, so it's going to be everywhere. A great people and a strong, there have not been ever the like, neither shall be any more after it, even to the years of many generations. And that great people, you know, it's not talking about men, you know. Because when you continue to read it, it explains it to you. Did you find it yet, bro?
No, I can't find it.
It's all good. I quoted it, you know. Scripture speak about the Lord. Lord tells us to hasten the day, you know. Can you hear that Wisdom of Solomon, bro?
Okay. This is Wisdom of Solomon 18 and 7. So if thy people was accepted both the salvation of the righteous and destruction of the enemies, for wherewith thou didst punish our adversaries, by the same thou didst glorify us whom thou hast called. Alright, so one end, hey, you got the wicked that's going to be destroyed. And on the, which, hey, that's that dead darkness is gloom. Alright? But on the other end, you got the elect.
Looking for a hastening.
Alright? That's going to get salvation.
Yeah.
The righteous, man. Alright, so that just, hey, like it says in 2nd Esdras, in order for us to get the place where all good things are, this place has to be overturned. Okay? Hey, the end of Esau was the beginning of Jacob, man, which
that's
we have forever.
That's right.
All right, so hey, this place got to go down for us to awake, man.
Mm-hmm.
So we look forward to that great and terrible day, man. We look forward to the coming of Yahweh Shai. It's a scripture in the New Testament. I forget how it's quite worded, but it's like, and them that rejoice at my coming.
Yeah. I mean, you pretty much hit it on the head. You pretty much hit it on the head.
Okay, you had a precept you wanted to bring out, Matthias. Go ahead.
Come. This is 2 Peter 3 and 12. It says, looking for and hastening to the coming of the day of God, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved in the elements.
Right, we're looking forward to the day where the fire. Hey, read the verse above that and then go.
This is 2 Peter 3 and 11. Seeing then all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of persons are ye to be in all holy conversations and godliness?
So first and foremost, what manner of man, you know, let's say, make sure we keep that spirit of humility. We understand the terror of the Lord, man. We get right through His Spirit, man. We have faith in knowing He's going to come and destroy this place. So you do get yourself correct. All right, through the Spirit, that's what we strive to do. So we have to behave as the man, as the manner of men of the Lord. And teach wholesome doctrine. Go ahead.
It says, looking forward and hastening to the coming of the day of God.
Looking forward to and hastening that day, man. That's our joy. So we teach on that, man. We go into the prophecies. Because the prophecy is the spirit of Yahweh Shai. Okay, so we look forward and hastening to that day, man. Go ahead.
It says, wherein the heavens being on fire shall be dissolved.
So we looking forward to the heavens being dissolved, man. Hey, that mushroom cloud. Okay, hey, and don't forget them nukes. They explode in the air. And it's going to be a blackout. So in every manner of the word dissolved, man, the heavens shall be dissolved. Go ahead.
And the elements shall melt with fervent heat.
Right. Like it says in 2 Andrews, it's going to be just sand and dust, man. This place is going to be a desert.
I got a scripture on the This is Isaiah 6:15. For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots, like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire.
Right. That's the great and terrible day of the Lord, man. That's the come.
Mm-hmm.
That's the end.
Coming with them chariots. You know, at the same time, nuclear missiles. Because that's what's bringing the salvation is the chariots.
That's right. The same thing that's... Because that scripture said the chariot is coming to bring fire and destruction, but also it's going to be to beam up the elect.
That's right.
And that was what Solomon specifically said was the same thing. They punish our enemies who have saved us. All right? Them chariots are going to destroy and save him the same, man.
Yeah, those ladies.
That's to talk about balance, man.
Yeah.
Hey, the Lord come with balance.
And he got his beasts of destruction, you know, with his ultimate weapon is those missiles he created, you know? That destroying wind that the scriptures speak about. You know, that hellfire, not no place burning, you know, that's under your feet. You know, that hellfire, man, that nuclear fire, man.
You have something else with that?
No, I was looking at, for you, those that rejoice. It says, like, pretty much, like, not only I, but all those that rejoice at his coming. You know, something to that effect. Yeah, I couldn't find it, though.
Good.
But I could just jump back to Joel, too.
You got something to quote?
Yeah, scripture.
Yeah, I'm looking for it right now.
Okay, well, go ahead, Matthias.
Yeah, this is verse 3. You might be looking for verse 12. But verse 3, it says, a fire devoured before them, and behind them a flame burning. You know? So a fire devoured before him, which is the that fire coming, man.
We've read verse 2, right?
Yeah, we read 2.
Okay.
You want me to read it?
No, that's cool.
It says, and behind them a flame burneth. The land of it is as the Garden of Eden before them, meaning it's life, you know. So today you see all the tall ass buildings, you see the highways and the cars and shit and all the houses, right? It says, and behind them a desolate wilderness, meaning nothing left, man. It's all desert. Everything's destroyed, man.
Fucking noobs, man. Hey, it said melt the elements.
Yeah.
It's going to turn this shit back to fucking dust, man.
Yo. It says, yea, and nothing shall escape them. The appearance of them is as the appearance of horses. Can a brother grab Revelation 9:16, I believe it is?
Okay.
It says, I'm going to read Joel 2 and 4 again. The appearance of them is as the appearance of horses, and as horsemen, so shall they run. Can you preach up there with that?
16?
I believe it's 9 and 16.
Yeah, horsemen?
Yeah, sure.
This is Revelation 9:16, and the number of the army of the horsemen were 200,000, and
200 million missiles, man. You know, all those missiles, man. And you fathom in your head like, oh my God, all those missiles. Well, hey. Russia got technology, man, where he could send one missile, but multiple warheads that's within that missile, you know? So it's a lot of nukes that's going to get dropped. Not just here on America, but Israel. Mm-hmm. Our land even going to get nuked, man. Why? Because it needs be, man.
Needs to be clear, man. Don't worry, we're going to have streets of gold.
Yeah. Go ahead, bro.
And I heard the number of them, and thus I saw the horses and the vision, and them
that... And the horse represents power, man, you know, because it speaks about in 2nd Ezra, the arrows, I believe it's 2nd Ezra, go ahead, bro.
This is 2nd Ezra 16 and verse 3, it says, a sword is sent among you, and who may turn it back? A fire is sent among you, and who may quench it?
Right. Hey, and what did it start with? It said the plagues are sent.
And it says, yeah. It says, a sword is sent among you, and who may turn it back? A fire is sent among you, and who may quench it? Plagues are sent unto you, and what is he that may drive them away?
Right, man. And one of those plagues is that fire, is that nuclear destruction. You know, you was holding that Zechariah, right? You want to bring it up, though?
It's more than Zechariah, right?
Yeah, we're going to jump back to it.
This is Zechariah chapter 14, verse 12. It says, and this shall be the plague wherewith the Lord will smite all the people that fought against Jerusalem.
Yep.
Their flesh shall consume
that fought against the elect, man. You know, that laid his hand on the apple of his eye, man.
God, the house of David.
And 2/3 of you, hey, you Idumean Hamites is included in that.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead, bro.
It says, their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet, and their eyes shall consume away in their holes.
And what can do that, man? That fire, man. Nuclear fire. Melting elements, like the brother said.
And describing it like this because you know what? You motherfuckers think it's going to be a quick death. No, the Lord is the master and ruler of all, including time perception. Are you going to feel it? You're going to feel your fucking eyes melting in your sockets, man. You're going to feel your tongue, your lying, filthy fucking tongue, all right, scoffing against the truth, okay, of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, lying against the spirit, blaspheming the spirit, man. You're going to feel your tongue melting in your mouth. Okay, you're going to feel your body consuming away. On top of all the other shit you went through before you made it to that type of shit. For those who do make it to that judgment. I'm not saying y'all niggas gonna do that. I'm saying for those who do make it to that judgment. Point is, some of Israel's gonna make it to that judgment, man. Okay, go ahead.
It says, and their tongues shall consume away in their mouth. Keep going.
That was the last verse.
Yeah,
that was it.
I'm going to go back to 2nd Ezra. Mm-hmm. It's 2nd Ezra chapter 16, verse 6. It says, may any man drive away a hungry lion in the wood.
Read the other verse right before that.
This 2nd Ezra 16, verse 5. It says, plagues are sent unto you, and what is he that may drive them away?
It's like the sword part. The sword?
Oh, okay.
Selachie, brother, Selachie.
This is 2nd Ezra chapter 16, verse 3. A sword is sent upon you, and who may turn it back?
Mm-hmm.
A fire is sent among you, and who may quench it?
And right. The Lord says his sword bathed in heaven, man.
God, you come down to Pinai Dumia.
Yep.
All right, so I got one quick precept for you for that sword. This is Job 20 and 24. He shall flee from the iron weapon, and the bow of steel shall strike him through. It is drawn and cometh out of the body. Yea, the glittering sword cometh out of his gall. Terrors are upon him. That's them nukes.
Yep.
Coming out of them silos,
yep.
Which 2 16 is going to get into, man. It's going to be shot across the ends of the earth, man. ICBM, man. Intercontinental ballistic missiles. Glorious death upon this place.
Hmm.
Okay? Mm-hmm. And the greatest salvation to the elect, which we hope and pray we're part of. A little more. All darkness shall be hid in his secret places. A fire not blown shall consume him.
Mm.
That's them nukes, man.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's nuclear fission or fusion, whichever one it is. I get confused on it. Whatever. All right? It's not your normal fucking light your TNT bomb, man. Or kindle a fire. No, man. Thermonuclear destruction.
What is it, like two atoms hitting each other or some
basically,
shit? Like,
yeah. It shall go ill with him that is left in his tabernacle. Alright,
right.
That's it.
And hey, it should go ill with him that's left in his tabernacle. You know, who's left on the shores of Idumea, of America, this place, man. Who's ever left on in America, man, you getting that. Whoever makes it through the race wars and the martial law and the race, you know what I'm saying, the famine, you know, and the pestilence, the diseases, and what all else the Lord send, the fucking animals that the Lord gonna send and eat motherfuckers, you know? Whoever make it past all that, if you left in America, you gonna suffer those missiles, man. Go ahead, bro.
It says, 2 Esdras, chapter 16, back in verse 6, it says, may any man drive away a hungry lion in the wood, or may anyone quench the fire in stubble when it have mm-hmm. begun to burn.
So, right, so once that flame kindled, you can't stop it. And once that lion come, that hungry lion that ain't ate for a week or two, you think you gonna stop him? You know? Go ahead, bro.
It says, may one turn again the arrow that is shot of a strong archer.
Mm-hmm.
The mighty Lord sendeth the plagues, and who is he that can drive them away? A fire shall go forth from his wrath, and who is he that may quench it?
Right.
He shall cast lightning.
The Lord finna show his indignation upon this place, man.
He shall cast lightnings, and who shall not fear? He shall thunder. And who shall not be afraid?
Mm-hmm.
The Lord shall threaten, and who shall not be utterly beaten to powder at his presence?
Beaten to powder, man. Getting your ass zapped.
Mm-hmm. It says, the earth quaketh, and the foundations thereof. The sea arises up with waves from the deep, and the waves of it are troubled.
Man, so earthquakes and tsunamis?
And the fishes thereof also before the Lord and before the glory of his power. For strong is his right hand that bendeth the bow. His arrows he shooteth are sharp
mm-hmm.
and shall not miss when they begin to be shot into the ends of the world.
And that's the point. You know, how can the actual arrow get shot into the ends of the world, man? You know? He's speaking in the terms as the in the words he had during that time.
Right.
So when he's seeing it, this just looks like an arrow, which a missile.
And I was going to say, don't forget Psalm 78:3. If I'm not mistaken, that's the correct chapter and verse. The Lord says, no, but it's not from parables. Okay. And also in Isaiah 28, it tells you the key, the guide to breaking this parable down.
Mm-hmm.
All right. It reads about the glittering sword and is now referring to it as a mighty man or as an archer and these arrows going to the ends of the world. And in the Job, it summed it up. The glittering sword, okay, fire not kindles coming out the earth.
Mm-hmm.
The missile silos, man. That's the strong arm, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right, a fire not blown, man. Okay, the Lord blow out the cold.
Yeah.
Hold it for me.
Lord, created the smith that blew up the coal and the fire.
Exactly, you know? Man. This is the Lord's weapon of indignation.
Isaiah 54, 16.
Exactly. This is the Lord's weapon. This is his doing, man. This is his end. This is what the prophecy is. Alright, just think about the old times. The Lord wanted to take down a kingdom. When he took down, let's say, Babylon, the Babylon Assyrian kingdom, he gave a prophecy. It was that another king was going to come take him down. You know, the Lord used his man to do shit. Alright, he using y'all to kill y'all self. Alright, y'all can fall into your own snare. He gave y'all the knowledge to make those weapons, and guess what? That's going to be your own destruction.
Keep wondering.
No, that was it. That was the point, because I know it's more. It's a whole lot more than 2nd Esdras, but we just don't, you know. Go ahead, bro.
Isaiah 54, 16. Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coal in the fire.
Right, so that's those scientists, you know. The Lord gave them the ability to create what they created, which is the atom bomb, the nuclear bomb, the hydrogen bomb.
And that bringeth forth an instrument for his work.
And what's his work, man? The day of the Lord. The day of destruction. That's his work. So those instruments, it speaks of his instruments of his indignation. The weapons of your indignation, I believe it says. You know? That's the instruments, man, is those nuclear missiles. You know?
And I have created the waster to destroy.
And what's that? The waster. I forgot. It was one of them motherfucking, I think his name, he one of them motherfucking Vanderbilt or.
Oh, yeah, the quote.
Yeah, the quote he said when they dropped that bomb on, I think it was Hiroshima. He said that we have become the waster or something to that effect, you know.
God, and this is Isaiah 13.
Go back to Revelation, though. Okay.
And the point, verse 5. Actually, I'm going to start at 1. The burden of Babylon, which Isaiah the son of Amos did see. Lift thee up a banner upon a high mountain, exalt his voice unto them. Shake the hand, they may go into the gates of the nobles, which is what we do. Alright, we reprove and rebuke and exhort, man. Alright, with long suffering, man, and true doctrine, man. Alright? Because the day of the Lord does come with salvation. We set that standard. Alright? For those that are set to receive that salvation. And then also, Jeremiah 28, we proclaim the downfall of this piece of shit kingdom.
That's right.
Alright? I have commanded Slotkin, shake the hand that they may go into the gates of the nobles. I have commanded my sanctified ones, have also called my mighty ones for mine anger, even them that rejoice in my highness. The noise of a multitude of the mountains like as of a great people, a tumultuous noise of the kingdoms of nations gathered together. The Lord of hosts marches the host of the battle.
Yep.
The Lord, hey, Zechariah, Zephaniah 3 and 8, man. The Lord want these people to come to the land of Jehoshaphat, man, the valley of Jehoshaphat.
That's right.
The valley.
Yeah.
That's his doing. He's setting that up. And that's the Lord's plan to have them nukes set up to come and destroy this land and also hit parts of the Middle East.
Yeah.
Including that same land where the battle's going to be at.
Because that's Armageddon, which in Hebrew is Harmagedon, which means pretty much mountain of troops, you know? So it's a whole mountain of troops that's in the Middle East. That's Armageddon. You know, that's the Valley of Jehoshaphat.
You got those troops and the missiles going to come as troops. Hey, verse 5. They come from a far country from the end of heaven. All right, even Yahweh and the weapons of his indignation to destroy the whole land.
That's right.
Hey, so the Lord going to come with destruction and he's going to have them nukes, which his weapons also wears destruction, man. He gonna have. Hey, he's the Lord of hosts, the Lord of armies. The nukes are armies. He gonna have actual armies fighting each other. Yep. He's coming with his armies, the host of heaven. He got his what is it called? When you just like sabotage
ambush.
Ambush. He got his ambush. Another set of army in the land.
Mm-hmm.
He set a whole ambush up. The Lord of hosts, Yahweh of hosts, man.
The man of war.
howl ye, for the day of Yahweh is at hand, and shall come as destruction from the Almighty. So this all comes to the day of the Lord, man. Total death and destruction. It's a day of darkness and not light, man. Death, destruction, nukes, and hey, even salvation for the elect.
Coming.
Okay, but there's more. You got more. We're going back to Joel.
Yeah, no, we was going to go back to the Revelation because we stepped up. Like, and then we're going to go back to Joel because that's, you know, that's where we stepped up. Go ahead, bro.
And thus I saw.
Oh, where you at?
This Revelation 9:17. And thus I saw the horses in the vision, and them that sat on them having breastplates of fire, and
Jackson,
and brimstones. And the heads of the horses were as the heads of lions, and out of their mouths issued fire and smoke and brimstone.
Right, which is the warhead once it explodes, man. It's a fierce explosion, man. That's why he said it's like lions, you know? Go ahead, bro.
By these three was the third part of men killed by fire and by the smoke and by brimstone, which issued out of their mouth.
Right, which issued out of the mouth, which is that nuclear destruction. It is more for what?
Not 19.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. For their power is in their mouths,
which is the warhead.
And in their tails,
and in their tails is how they propel to the other side, to the other end of the earth. You know,
tails were like unto serpents, and had heads, and with them they do hurt.
And with the heads they do hurt, which is the war heads explode.
What's the next verse saying?
Yeah.
20.
And the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues yet represent not of the works of their hands, that they should not worship devils and idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and of wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk, neither represent.
Oh, that's it. That's saying, but you, there you go. Even after all that, niggas still ain't gonna repent. That's why when we come down, Lord willing, it's us. The elect come down off them chariots, man. Mm-hmm. Hey. But to go back into Joel, the second chapter, I'm going to read the fourth verse again. It says, the appearance of them is as the appearance of horses. So we just, you know, John seen the horses and Joel's having the same vision. And the horses is the chariots. And as horsemen, so shall they run. Like the noise of chariots on the tops of mountains shall they leap, like the noise of a flame of fire that devoureth the stubble, as a strong people set in battle array. Before their face the people shall be much pained. All faces shall gather blackness. You'll be burned up. They shall run like mighty men. They shall climb the wall like men of war. And they shall march every one on his ways, and they shall not break their ranks.
Hey, the nukes ain't going to bump into each other. They're not going to miss their target. They're not going to fucking lose GPS focus. They're not going to get stopped by no motherfucking missile defense systems. None of that, man.
It says, neither shall one thrust another. They shall walk every one in his path. You know, so wherever it's destined to hit, that's where it's going. It says, and when they fall upon the sword, they shall not be wounded.
Right, no defensive missile defense systems gonna stop them, man. And these nations are boasting of them now. All right, China's boasting of the, I think it's called the Red Death, the Red Rain. I forget what it's called, but it's so. I think that's the one. But they got the one that's so fast it goes, it just goes through the defense systems because they can't catch it.
Damn.
And then Russia just boasts of how they just got one. they just can't be stopped. They can't be detected and shit. They can get themselves with them nukes right to your fucking base. You won't even notice it. Right to your land.
Hmm.
All right, and they flying them fucking planes right around America that can carry nukes. All right, and they flying right off the around this place, man, ready at any time. All right, the Lord is setting all this up, man. He said he mustered the host of the battle. He's doing all this, man.
Yeah.
There should be wars and rumors of wars, and he's controlling all that. The heart of the king is in the Lord's hands. And he turns to whichever way he will it.
That's right.
Go ahead. What's Elijah?
Let's go. Joel 2, verse 9. They shall run to and fro in the city. They shall run upon the wall. They shall climb up upon the houses. They shall enter in at the windows like a thief. Meaning everything. It's going to destroy everything, man. You know? Uh-huh. The earth shall quake before them. You know, a brother can grab Isaiah, the 24th chapter.
They shall run to and fro.
You know?
That's what I'm saying. That's the spirit.
I'll read verse 10 when you brothers get it. It says, the earth shall quake before them, the heavens shall tremble, the sun and the moon shall be dark, and the stars shall withdraw their shine. You know? That mushroom cloud coming, man, after that destruction, man. You know?
Mm-hmm. That nuclear blackout.
Mm-hmm.
And also, that don't forget that the nukes come with the chariots of the Lord. And also says the chariot's going to block the sun and moon out too.
Yeah, kind of.
That's why it says it's going to be a dead darkness, man, and not light, man. It's going to be truly dark out there, man. All right, it's going to be... Hey, Yahweh Shah wish for the fires when every side, man. So imagine how that end structure is going to be, man. This grand finale. Go ahead, somebody.
Okay, this is Isaiah chapter 24, verse 20. It says, the earth shall reel to and fro like a drunkard and shall be removed like...
No, start up with 19.
19, con. It says, this is Isaiah 24:19. The earth is utterly broken down. The earth is clean, dissolved. The earth is moved exceedingly.
Yeah, the elements shall melt with fervent heat, man.
That's right.
You know? And they ain't talking about the whole earth. It's talking about whatever parts that's destined.
Right.
You know? So we know America's going to be completely destroyed. You know?
Right, because they were Earth Dead, if I'm not mistaken, it's Arzah, which means land. So it just means land. That specific land, right? Okay, where the nukes going to hit? Mm-hmm. All right, it says it's going to be dissolved, like it said in Peter's, we're just talking about them nukes. Since these things shall be dissolved, man. All right, melting the elements, like the brother said.
Kind of says, verse 20. Earth shall reel to and fro like a drunkard, and shall be removed like a cottage, and the transgression thereof shall be heavy upon it, and it shall fall and not rise again.
Exactly. So now you know, now you understand that number in Revelation when it says 200 million missiles. It can shake the earth, you know what I'm saying? That's man. You know, back in Joel 2, verse 11. It says, and Yahweh Basham Yahushai shall utter his voice before his army, for his camp is very great, for he is strong that executed his word, for the day of the Lord is great and very terrible, and who can abide it? It says, therefore also now, saith the Lord, turn ye even to me with all your heart, and with fasting, and with weeping, and with mourning, and rent your heart, and not your garments.
Right. That's why Peter said, what manner of man are you to be? Knowing this to come, man. The Lord said, return to me with fasting. Okay? Now, of course, that does mean that we do, and it's truth, we do fast. But also, it's a certain type of fast the Lord requires, man. I'm finna get it real quick. If you don't mind, brother. This is Isaiah 58. And 6, is not this the fast that I have chosen? To loose the bands of wickedness, to undo the heavy burdens, and to let the oppressed go free, and that ye break every yoke? All right, it's to do this work, man. To go out there. All right, to do justice unto the fatherless and the widow, man, to the needy. Okay? Take off that yoke, man. Give them this truth, because it says the truth shall make you free. So how do we do that? This we teach wholesome doctrine. Is it not to deal thy bread to the hungry? Give to the truth. Yahusha is the bread of life. And if thou bring the poor that are cast out to thy house, and thou seest the naked, that thou cover him, that thou have not him thyself from thy own flesh. Alright, and Hosea makes it clear that we're supposed to have Yahweh as our covering. So that's what we give him. Then shall thy light break forth as the morning, and thy help shall spring forth speedily, and thy righteousness shall go before thee. The glory of Yahweh shall be thy reward. Just like you go back.
Yeah. Back in Joel 2:13, it says, "And rent your heart and not your garments, and turn unto the Lord your power."
Right, so that's one of the things you got to do to get in this truth, man. You got to follow up the Yahweh and Yahushai, not lean to your own understanding, like it says in Proverbs. Mm-hmm. All right, don't be an emotional creature. Be a man of reason. All right, be a man of understanding, a man of integrity. All right, because to have understanding means you follow after knowledge and understanding, which would be following after the law, which is following after Yahweh. It was when Solomon that says, "Wisdom will meet thee in every thought." So you will filter this. You will filter your life and how you move and operate through the Spirit and the Scriptures.
Yeah.
It'll be a frontlet before your eyes.
And like how you said, you know, you said follow after Yahweh Shai. And how do you do that? You follow the men that He set up. You know, and you mimic those men. You follow those men.
Mark the perfect man.
You know, because then when you read Sirach, which is a book of wisdom, and they tell you to be in the midst of the elders. So then who? Then you ask yourself, who is the elders then? Because a part of wisdom and understanding is you know who your elders are.
Right. You know? Learn from.
You know who you learn from because you're continuing in something that you have learned, being assured of who you learn from. You know? So it's a lot that, you know. So a part of wisdom, you know, is knowing that. But back in Joel 2 verse 13 again, "And rent your heart and not your garments, and take unto the Lord your power, and turn unto the Lord your power, Slaki. For He is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness, and repented Him of the evil. Who knoweth if He will return and repent, and leave a blessing behind Him, even a meat offering and a drink offering unto the Lord your power?"
That's why we serve Yahweh Bashar, our shout out fear and trembling, man. And no room for pride in this thing, man. We do deserve death. But it's written, He is coming with mercy, man. But we hope to be those who receive it.
Okay. The sure mercies of David.
Okay.
It says, "Blow the trumpet in Zion, sanctify fast."
So do the work. Sanctify fast, man. There you go, man. Teach other men to do that work, man. To join in that fast with you. Go ahead.
"Call a solemn assembly. Gather the people, sanctify the congregation, assemble the elders."
Separate the congregation, assemble the elders.
That's what it says.
Alright? So there's still order when you're getting this thing, man. It was Moses and 70 elders.
Hey, because a part of wisdom, it says to do nothing without counsel.
That's right.
Who was you getting counsel from then?
That's right.
Where's the rank and file? Where's your...
Even Paul, being since people want to keep saying they learned directly from Yahweh Shai. Even Paul, an actual man who learned directly from Yahweh Shai, went and got counsel when he had a dispute with a man. Or he would have got counsel from the apostles.
That was
keep order.
The dispute about circumcision.
Exactly.
You know, and he went to the apostles, man, and whatever they said, that's what it went with.
Just like it says in Acts, they stuck to the apostles' doctrine.
and Paul was right the whole time. But what did he do? He kept order and went to Peter, James, you know.
Hey, the example our elders gave us, we were speaking about it earlier.
Yeah.
The Cornelius thing. They knew it was true, but they didn't want to step on the toes of the men that were above them or teach something too heavy for those in that time to become a stumbling block. So they held on to it, man. They did things in order. And the Lord worked it all out.
They said they wasn't going to teach it.
Right.
But they kicked them out anyway. You know?
Right. And we got holy men over us, man. We got true righteous pastors over us. So it's a big difference this time.
Yeah.
I'm just giving that was an example, man. on how to keep order. So if you to do it properly, one would do it. Go ahead.
I'm reading verse 16, Joel 2:16. Gather the people, sanctify the congregation, assemble the elders, gather the children and those that suck the breast. Let the bridegroom go forth of his chamber, and the bride come out of her closet.
Good prepare for Yahweh Shai.
Mm-hmm. And the bride is the elect, you know, coming out the closet.
Right.
Let the priests, the ministers of Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shai, weep between the porch and the altar, and let them say, spare thy people, O Lord, and give not thy heritage to reproach, that the heathen should rule over them. Wherefore should they say among the people, where is their power? Then will the Lord be jealous for his land and pity his people. Yea, the Lord will answer and say unto his people, behold, I will send you corn and wine and oil, and ye shall be satisfied therewith, and I will no more make you a reproach among the heathen.
Right, that's this truth, the corn and wine and the oil. All right, the Lord gave us this doctrine. Right, and that, it says in Baruch, with that sees these people gathered together by the word.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Yahweh Shai at the Last Supper said he is that bread and that wine. All right, which was the testimony, man, the Old and New Testament. Right? You got anything? Mm-hmm. I'm going to just keep reading.
Yeah, so I'm just going to keep reading.
Okay, come on.
Verse 20. Because
we have points we actually want to slide. Go ahead.
Verse 20. It says, but I will remove far off from you the northern army, and will drive him into a land barren and desolate, with his face toward the east sea, and his hinder part towards the utmost sea.
Okay. Right. And this is basically the whole aspiration of the sit down, man. That's a task we're entering there, man. Alright, the day that the Lord desires, man. The day of vengeance. Like it says in Isaiah, vengeance in his heart. Alright, and it said that the Lord is going to have a northern army. Read it over.
It says, but I will remove far off from you the northern army.
Right, so the troops that do come to the streets of America will eventually go to this land. And not only them, but all these other armies, man, because it says in Zephaniah 3 and 8, once again, that's the Lord's determination to gather the nations and pour upon them his indignation. All right? To bring them down to that valley. In fact, I got a pretty stars. Oh, you can read it. Bring out any points you have, Matthias.
I'm going to read 20 again. It says, but I will remove far off from you the northern army, and will drive him into a land barren and desolate, with his face toward the east sea, and his hinder parts toward the utmost sea. Which pretty much the east sea is speaking about the Euphrates, and the hinder part, you know, which is behind them, is talking about which is the Mediterranean Sea, which is that area in between there, you know, which is Syria and Israel, and you know, what's right there, the country Jordan, you know, all the little countries right there, you know, and his stink shall come up. His ill savor shall come up, because he hath done great things. And that's the judgment, you know. Revelation, so it says, the sins have reached up unto the sky.
Okay.
You know? You follow through?
Oh yeah, Joel 3. I want to read the 2 and then go to 3.
Joel 3, 2, verse 2?
Yeah, basically, okay. I'll start at 1.
I can read it, I'm there. Right. It's Joel 3 and 1. It says, for behold, in those days and in that time when I shall bring the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem. Salakia, I read that wrong. Let me slow down. It says, for behold, in those days and in that time when I shall bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem, which the Lord is going to turn it around, bring this out. Mm-hmm. I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat. And will plead with them there for my people, and for my heritage Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land.
Right. The Lord is coming with this great destruction for Israel's sake. Cool. I'm gonna get this crease up. But the Lord is bringing this great destruction for Israel's sake, man. And Isaiah tells you that he's giving nations for ransom for us. So it says he's gonna plead for us, man. That's why he's doing this. That's why it says both with this same thing, he's gonna bring destruction and salvation, man. Alright, y'all should have never touched the apple of the Lord's eye. Alright, great. Death and destruction is coming to this fucking earth, man. And 2017 may just be that year. Alright? The Lord's going to start shaking things up. And when them plagues start hitting, it's going to start coming rapidly, man. Hey, it's going to be like that snowball effect, man. It's going to get bigger and bigger, man. Alright? As it comes downhill, man. And it's going to crush everything, man. The Lord's going to bring that hammer. You got something?
This is Malachi 4:1. It says, "For behold, they cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yea, all that do wickedly shall be stubble. And the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall neither leave them root nor branch, but unto you that fear my name shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings, and shall go forth and grow up as the cause of the stave." Yeah, man, so that's what's going to happen, you know. The Lord is coming back. I'm going to read the scripture right here, just to link it up. This is Luke chapter 12, verse 49. "I am come to send fire on the earth, and what will I if it be already kindled?" You know, so the things first, you know, the prophecy's got to come to pass, you know, the pestilence, the famine, you know, the RFID chip, because a lot of people will get killed, you know, over that, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And then you got martial law. A lot of Jake's going to get killed, you know, by martial law, you know what I'm saying? But then after you got all these race riots and stuff, you know.
Well, race riots getting going, man. You see, they got this damn video circulating now. With these damn niggers, asshole black fucks, kidnapping some Trump supporters, and they talking shit about him and shit, about the whole thing. Just fueling the fire of racial tension. That's it.
Then somebody do me and Hamites. Mm-hmm. They fit for destruction.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I was saying, like, you're gonna have all these race riots and stuff. So the fire is gonna be kindled, but then the Lord's gonna come back. And it says all that's pride and that do wickedly should be left in stubble. And that's with the ICBM nuclear missiles, and also with the help of them laser beams coming out their chariots. You know?
Mm-hmm. You guys have 43:3. Go ahead, buddy.
I got just to back the brother up, 2 Kings 15. And 13. "They that till the ground shall mourn, for their seed shall fail through the blasting and hail, and with the fearful constellation, with just the way of famine." Woe to, because I'm just start there, because I'm start up. Verse 10. It's 9. Yeah, 9. It says, "And therefore saith the Lord," the 2 Kings 15:9. "And therefore saith the Lord, I will surely avenge them, and receive unto me all the innocent blood from among them. Behold, my people was led as a flock to the slaughter. I will not suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt." That's the Lord turning back our captivity. "But I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm, and smite Egypt with plagues as before, and will destroy all the land thereof." And what did all Egypt go through? You know, their crops died, all their cattle died. When your crops and cattle die, what's that? That's a famine. You know? They had, man, 3 days of darkness, the locusts, you know, the lice, the frogs, the flies. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It says,
death of the firstborn.
Yeah, kind. Yeah. It says, "And smite Egypt with plagues as before, and will destroy all the land thereof. Egypt shall mourn, and the foundation of it shall be smitten with the plague and punishment that the Most High shall bring upon it." You know, like the brother said, all that is coming, and after all that, the missiles coming, man. "They that till the ground shall mourn, For their seed shall fail through the blasting in hell and with a fearful constellation. You know, which that's a famine. Woe to the world and them that dwell therein. For the sword and their destruction draweth nigh, and one people shall stand up to fight against another, and swords in their hands. They're going to get race wars right there, man. It says, for there shall be sedition among men in invading one another. They shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their own power. So bye-bye 911. Bye-bye worrying about a police or what a governor or what a fucking anybody got to say, man. It says the course in their actions shall stand in their own power. So it's going to be purge night every night, man. It says, a man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able. There go your martial law. Mm-hmm. For because of their pride, the city shall be troubled, the houses shall be destroyed, and men shall be afraid. A man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, but shall destroy their houses with the sword and spoil their goods because of the lack of bread and for great tribulation. It's going to go down in this place, man. All the movies that you see and all that bullshit happening in the movies, man, it's going to happen here, man. You're going to be in a fucking movie. Behold, saith the Most High, I will call together all the kings of the earth to reverence me, which are from the rising of the sun, from the south, from the east, and Lebanus, to turn themselves one against another. So, they go your gathering, you know, your Joel, the third chapter, Valley of Jehoshaphat. And repay the things that they have done to them.
Right, man. This is recompense for what you've done to Israel. Isaiah the 10th chapter makes it clear, man. And the Lord said, "You're his the rod of his anger." But then he's gonna come and turn and destroy you, man. All right? He tells us to just go through what we gotta go through for yet a little while, man. And his anger shall be removed from us, man. And he shall bring it upon you and destroy Babylon. Okay? So you guys got a great destruction. Imagine how great, terrible shit we went through from hell, from Greece to Rome,
man.
To even going through the hell and persecution we went through during the fucking Dark Ages, man. Israel wasn't cool and popular back then, man. We wasn't ruling. That was a time of fucking idolatry, really, man. Okay? And then fucking slavery. And then this fucking hell even now, man. So imagine what the fuck you guys got coming, man. The nukes is a great starter to what the fuck you guys got coming. This ain't the end. It's the end of the begin. It's the end of this shit, which is just the beginning of more judgment, man. And we're gonna use the remainder of that fire, man, to burn these fucking Edomites off, man, once and for good. Come. This is going to go to that Joel's third chapter.
Come. This is Isaiah chapter 43, verse 3. It says, for I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thou Savior. It says, I gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Sheba for thee. Since thou wast precious in my sight, thou hast been honorable, and I have loved thee. Therefore will I give man for thee, and people for thy life. Fear not, for I am with thee. I will bring thy seed from the east, and gather thee from the west. I will say to the north, give up, and to the south, keep not back. Bring my sons from far, and my daughters from the ends of the earth.
That's right. Yahweh Bashan Yashas is going to redeem his children.
That's right.
All right, and he says he's going to do it by what? By giving the other man's life for ransom for us. And it says that the Valley of Jehoshaphat, and this Joel 3:2, I will also get thou nation and will bring them down into the Valley of Jehoshaphat, and will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations and part of my land.
Yep.
So a large part of the Lord's judgment is going to be focused on that. So the Lord got this all planned out. Man, that's why the Middle East is so fucking riled up now. He already got the fire kindling now, man. It's fucked up over there. It's going to get worse and worse and worse. It's going to get worse and worse faster and faster, man. More death. And it's going to be fucking evils all across the world, man. Every fucking world, man. For what y'all have done for the Israelites, man. And it said the Lord is going to protect his elect, man. All right, this time you guys are going to be sorrowful, man. And we're going to fucking laugh. right?
If I get this back in Second Ezra. That was it on that Isaiah? Was there more in there?
Yeah, I think that was it.
Back in 2 Ezra 15:21 now, it says, like as they do yet this day unto my chosen. So it's still been done unto his chosen till this day. So will I do also and recompense in their bosom, thus saith the Lord power. My right hand shall not spare the sinners, and my sword shall not cease over them that shed innocent blood upon the earth. The fire is gone forth from his wrath and has consumed the foundations of the earth, and the sinners like the straw that is kindled. Woe to them that sin and keep not my commandments, saith the Lord. You know? I'm ending on that, man. You brothers got a precept? Well, I was thinking about, since we talked about the destruction, we might as just go into the salvation. Because a part of that is the salvation.
In the Joel 2nd chapter?
Nah, it was more than that. It was more than that.
It's on going to the salvation, right? I know this 3rd chapter does. Because I still had wanted to hit this Joel 3 and 9, leading up until back to that vast chosen fact. But it goes into some of the salvation. Mostly goes to the recompense. But it's still part of it. What you want to do?
It don't matter. We can keep going.
All right. Well, hear what you was saying, Joel, 2nd chapter, when you left off.
This is Joel 2, verse 21. It says, fear not, O land, be glad and rejoice, for the Lord will do great things. Be not afraid, ye beasts of the field, for the pastures of the wilderness do spring, for the tree beareth her fruit, the fig tree and the vine do yield their strength. Be glad then, ye children of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your power.
Kyle, we was talking about it. We did say verse up to verse 20. I remember. I was just hot. Huh. I was on the 3rd chapter. If I'm hit this 39, that's cool then.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, this is Joel 3:9. proclaim ye this among the Gentiles, prepare war, wake up the mighty men, let all the men of war draw near, let them come up. Beat your plowshares into swords, and your pruning hooks into spears, let the weak say I am strong. Alright, and that's what's going on now, man. That's why the Lord said wars and rumors of wars. Alright, we got conflicts arising from nation to nation, man. Okay, if you keep up with current events and watch the videos, man, we post the videos. Alright, various brothers, Jim and Sharon Mothbah does a wonderful job, the brother Yashawamba.
Yeah.
Alright, Fear the brothers Page Fear the Most High.
Yep.
That brother's in London.
Yeah, brother. Yep.
And a lot of brothers, you know, Coastal Apostles.
Hey, brother in LA. Kind. Like, brother, behold, I come quickly.
Kind. The brother Ariala, or especially the algorithms, can keep you well updated. Shit. Okay?
All the little financial, you know, mm-hmm. you know, breakdowns and shit.
Elder Malcolm.
I was just going to say that because, you know, they ought to be talking about it. I don't understand nothing of it. You know? Be like, yeah, okay. So America going down. That's all I heard out of all that, you know?
All right, kind. These other nations are rising up, man. And guess what? They all get nukes. That goes to that 200 million missiles, man. They all keep increasing numbers and keep increasing numbers.
Mm-hmm.
And they all saying they strong, man. And they all finna get ready to battle to Syria, man. That's when Russia's gathering them up and leading them, according to Ezekiel 38. And it's happening in real life. Assemble yourselves and come, all ye heathen. Get Zephaniah 3:8. I don't want to leave that out. Assemble yourselves and come, all ye heathen. And gather yourselves together round about. They're the cause thy mighty ones to come down, O Yahweh. Alright? And that's the Lord mustering the host, man. It says gather yourselves. And he's doing that, man. Over into that land, Syria. Let the heathen be wakened and come up to the valley of Jehoshaphat. For thou will I sit to judge all the heathen round about. All right? Hey, the Lord is going to come to that land, man. He's going to visit this earth, man. Hey, everybody want to meet God, right? Join the army. Hey, you have a great shot. Hey, but every eye shall see, and every knee shall bow. Mm-hmm. All right? And no one confess Yahweh Basham Yahshai, man, is Lord, man. Hey, but if you really want to get a personal close-up look, join the army, man. Go join, in fact, go to Israel and join their army, man. This is to you heathens. And to you people that want to disagree with us, you have a better bet of going to do that, man. Because otherwise, you're just disagreeing with us and scoffing. You're going to just get beheaded. All right? Bring them here, then behead them, man. All right, for there will I sit to judge all the heathen round about. That was it. That's all we're on that. He gets Zephaniah, so we can wrap it up.
Kindness is Zephaniah 3 and 8. Therefore wait ye upon me, saith the Lord, until the day that I rise up to the prey, for my determination is to gather the nations, that I may assemble the kingdoms, to pour upon them my indignation, even all my fierce anger, for all the earth shall be devoured with the fire of my jealousy.
Right, the Lord is going to bring a great destruction to that land, man, where he's gathering these armies at, man. He's going to pour out all his judgments, man. Okay, so imagine how terrible it's going to be over there. Imagine the plagues is going to come to this fucking place. Because it says it's going to send that fire right through all the earth. All right, and that's not talking about the nuclear fire, man. Now, the nukes were in America, obviously. But that's talking about the fire of judgments, man. Like it talks about in Deuteronomy, I think the 32nd chapter. The fire, the fire is deep as hell, and it goes through a list of judgments. Fire is affliction, man. All right, y'all got anything else?
Shit, I was gonna say, keep reading through. Let's read through to the end of Joel 3.
Okay. That's what I was thinking about earlier when I said to the end, when I first said, let's read the whole chapter. Then you said just verse 20, and we started. This is Joel 3 and 13. Put ye in the sickle, for the harvest is ripe. Come, get you down, for the press is full. The fats overflow, for their wickedness is great. Hey, like the brother quoted earlier in the Revelations, man. They sins are rich to the heavens, man. And they cup of wickedness over fucking floweth, man. Multitudes.
Yeah, I piss up you real fast. Just off. This is Revelation 14, verse 15. 14. It says, and I looked and behold a white cloud, and upon the cloud one set like unto the Son of Man, having on his head a golden crown, and in his hand a sharp sickle. And another angel came out of the temple, crying with a loud voice to him that sat on the cloud, thrust in thy sickle and reap, for the time is come for thee to reap, for the harvest of the earth is ripe. You know, it just said that, you know, it was ripe.
That's where they get the image of the Grim Reaper from, really. Alright? They understand, these devils, they look, all things the devil, man. Everything comes from the scriptures, man.
It says, and he that sat on the cloud thrust in his sickle on the earth, and the earth was reaped. And another angel came out of the temple, which is in heaven, he also having a sharp sickle. And another angel came out from the altar, which had power over fire, and cried with a loud cry to him that had the sharp sickle, saying, thrust in thy sharp sickle, and gather the clusters of the vine of the earth, for her grapes are fully ripe. And the angel thrust in his sickle into the earth, and gathered the vine of the earth, and cast it into the great wine press, I'm getting excited, of the wrath of the Most High.
The wrath of the Most High, man. Hey, y'all gonna get squeezed the fuck out. Mm-hmm. You want to put the squeeze on somebody, fucking at you, motherfucker, and you're gonna get squeezed out, man. All your fucking brain grapes gonna get squeezed out, your fucking asshole, mm-hmm. Fucking yakko, whack, jack, fuck.
It says, verse 20, and the wine press was tried without the city, and blood came out of the wine press, even into the horse's bridle, by the space of 1,006 furlongs.
Hey, that's a lot of blood, man. Up to the horse's bridle, man. You know how tall a goddamn horse is, man?
The slain of the earth shall be from one end to another.
That's the spirit. I know my fucking head. I'm going to get back to this. That just fucked me up. Joel 3 and 14. Multitudes in the valley of decision. For the day of the Lord is near in the valley of decision. Mm-hmm. Hey, and it says that second, we got to get 2nd verse 13.
Bro, that's the spirit, right? Because why am I going to Isaiah 63? Because it said he tried the winepress alone. We just read Revelation. It says an angel in a white cloud thrust in a sickle and reap, you know. And he said, I reaped alone, you know. He squished the grapes. He tried the winepress. And I'm just get that because that's symbolic of him, 2nd verse 13, coming and actually, you know, this is Isaiah 63rd chapter, first verse, it says, who is this that cometh from Edom with dyed garments from Bozrah? This that is glorious in his apparel, traveling in the greatness of his strength.
Yahweh Shai said, I should not meet thee as a man. Mm-hmm. So I can say, brother, go ahead.
No, I was going to say the greatness of his strength is that white cloud, man. It's that chariot. And with the multitudes of angels, man, in heaven, man. That army he's coming with.
The Lord of hosts, indeed.
It says, I that speak in righteousness, mighty to save. Wherefore art thou red in thine apparel, and thy garments like him that treadeth in the wine fat? That wine press that was treaded, man, that came to the horse's bridle. Who led that charge, man? Yahweh Shai. This is who it's speaking of. It says, and thy garments like him that treadeth in the wine fat. I have tried the wine press alone, and of the people there was none with me. For I will tread them in my anger, and trample them in my fury, and their blood shall be sprinkled upon my garments, and I will stain all my raiment. You know?
He's going to get his hands dirty. He's going to do this himself.
Yep.
Because verse 4. Yeah, I'm trying to bring it down. It's a lot.
No, it's a lot, bro. Verse 4 says, for the day of vengeance is in my heart. You know? So the Lord is heated, man. He can't wait, man. He waiting for the Father to say, you know, it's time. You know, go. You know? In the year of my redeemed, it's come.
And it goes, there you go. It goes hand to hand, man. It goes hand to hand. Destruction and salvation. He just went through this great tale of his killing these heathens, these nations, these peoples, or has garments so bloody to say the year of my redeemed is come.
I got a precept for
that. Hey, even Mario had to fuck Bowser up to get his princess back.
This is Habakkuk 3:8. It says, was Yahweh displeased against the rivers? Was thy anger against the rivers? Was thy wrath against the sea, that thou didst ride upon thy horses and thy chariots of salvation? You know? So that lets you know it was that destruction and it was that salvation, man. Back in Joel, was I reading? Oh, the second edge.
This is 2nd Ezra chapter 13, verse 18. It says, now understand I the things that are laid up in the latter days.
No, third one.
Okay. Yeah. It says, this is 2nd Ezra 13:1. And it came to pass after 7 days, I dreamed a dream by night. And lo, there rose a wind from the sea that it moved all the waves thereof. And I beheld, and lo, that man waxed strong with the thousands of heaven. And when he turned his countenance to look, all things trembled that were seen.
Did it say the man came out of the sea?
It says, and lo, there arose a wind from the sea that it moves all the waves thereof. And behold, and I beheld, and lo, that man waxed strong with the thousands of the heaven. Uh-huh. And when he turned his countenance to look, all the things trembled that were seen under him.
Mm-hmm.
And whensoever the voice went out of his mouth, all they burnt that right. heard his voice, like as the fire felleth when it filleth
like as the earth
fire.
Mm-hmm.
Like as the earth fell.
Like as the earth felleth when it filleth the fire.
Which is those laser beams.
It says, keep going.
Mm-hmm.
It says, and after this I beheld, and lo, there was gathered together a multitude of men out of number, So like from the four winds of heaven.
So wait a minute, the Lord's gonna have the chariots gonna work throughout all the land, man. But that greatest destruction that he's gonna go into now is gonna be in the Middle East, in the Valley of Decision, man. Go ahead.
It says to subdue the man that came out of the sea.
Mm-hmm. So that's seen in Independence Day, man, when they had all the world armies gathered, you know, and aliens came. Then they got to fighting against the aliens, you know. So during that world war, they don't stop fighting each other and try to fight against the Lord when he comes.
Uh-huh. It says, but I beheld, and lo, he had graved himself a great mountain and flew upon it. But I would have seen the region or place where out the hill was graven, and I couldn't. Mm-hmm. Not.
It was a mighty ship, man. A big ass ship. You know, whatever.
It says, and after this I beheld, and lo, all they which were gathered together to subdue him were sore afraid, and yet durst to fight.
Mm-hmm. And the Lord put the spirit in them to fight.
And lo, as he saw the violence of the multitude that came, he neither lift up his hands, nor held sword, nor any instrument of war, but only I saw that he sent out of his mouth as it had been a blast of fire, and out of his lips a flaming breath, and out of his tongue he cast out sparks and tempests. And they were all mixed together, the blast of fire, the flaming breath, and the great tempest, which fell with violence.
And fell.
Mm-hmm.
That's like, and fell with violence upon the multitude.
And fell with violence upon the multitude, man. Laser beam zapping your ass. It was all gathered in one. You know? Go there, bro.
It says...
So you're getting the scene from two movies right here off this one scripture, man. From War of the Worlds with, well, who's that? Tom Cruise? And for Independence Day with Will Smith, man. Even on the second one, you know? Shows you the war in heaven. They fighting in the skies, man. Go ahead.
It says, and filled with
violence. This lines directly up with Revelation, the 12th chapter, when it says, and there was war in heaven. Satan and his angels fought against Michael and his angels. Michael going to be in those chariots as well, man. He's going to be with Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Shai is leading it.
It says, and filled with violence upon the multitude, which was ready to fight, and burnt them.
Right. Prideful motherfuckers, man. And that's what they're really getting prepared for. And they mad, they think them nukes is gonna be used for outer space. They don't plan to use them shit on each other. They gonna think that's their last weapon, that last line of defense against an outer space attack. They always show you that in the movies. Well, let's nuke them.
Mm-hmm.
It's never really meant for fucking Earth. America used what was the two bombs called? They used them two bombs in Hiroshima and Nagasaki to flex, because that's the prophecy. Really, after that, It was just they trying to fight against the Lord. The Lord set that trap on them, man. They fell into their own snare. Now all the nations got it, man. Now all the heathens getting strong and finna use it, man. They all ready to blow America off the fucking map.
Mm-hmm.
And it will happen. Go ahead.
It says, and filled with violence upon the multitude which was prepared to fight, and burnt them up every one. So that upon a sudden of an innumerable multitude, nothing was to be perceived but only dust and the smell of smoke. It says, when I saw this, I was afraid. Afterward saw I, the same man came down from the mountain and called unto him another peaceable multitude.
Okay. So with that destruction comes salvation as well. And slavery. You want to read the next one? We're going to go back to Joel 3. This is Joel 3. I'm going to hit 14 again. Multitudes in the Valley of Decision, for the day of Yahweh is near the Valley of Decision. That's what the brother just read in that second Aries 13. That great destruction that's coming to this place. The sun and the moon shall be darkened, and the stars shall withdraw their shining. The chariots gonna block this plate, the light out too, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right, just the missiles out. Yahweh also shall rot Zion out of his voice on Jerusalem, and the heavens and earth shall shake. There's a go. The earth is going to reel, man. But Yahweh shall be the hope of his people and the strength of the children of Israel. Mm-hmm. All right, and that's what we have proclaimed. The downfall of this place, all right, like the prophets of old, all right, and the salvation to his elect, to Israel. All right, Israel of Yahshua, of Yahweh Basham Yahushai. Yahweh Basham Yahushai, man. So shall you know that I am Yahweh, your power, dwelling in Zion, my holy mountain. Then shall Jerusalem be holy, and there shall no strangers pass through her anymore. All right? So where the fuck do you get that everybody can make it, man? Any nation can get into the kingdom of heaven. No, this is for Israel, man. Every nation has been fucking us up, man. This is the Maccabees, man. 2:10. They getting recompense. And it shall come to pass in that day that the mountain shall drop down new wine, and the hill shall flow with milk. And all the rivers of Judah shall flow with waters, and a fountain shall come forth of the house of Yahweh, and shall water the valley of Shittim. Egypt shall be a desolation, and Edom shall be a desolate wilderness. For the violence against the children of Judah, because they have shed innocent blood in their land. Mm-hmm. So you Edomites, all right, which are so-called white men, you Hamites, you Africans, you Moabites, you Chinese, you Ishmaelites, you Arabs, okay, Ammon, you Japanese, Japhet, which are island nations like Australia, your original Australians, you know, you Hawaiians, okay, and you various nations, man, this is y'all judgment, man. So y'all, when this hell comes to earth, you're gonna know why it comes, man. What you've done to the children of the Most High. The true creator of all things has true seed on this earth, man. Actual children. That's the so-called Negroes, Latins, Native Americans. And you've all tried to know of us, man. We've bent over and let you walk over our backs. And Heavenly Father, Yahweh Basham Yahushai is displeased, man. He's going to bring great destruction for that. Alright? Especially to you Edomites. But Judah shall dwell in safety, Shalaki. But Judah shall dwell forever. I started about that Deuteronomy immediately when I read that precept, Shalaki. But Judah shall dwell forever, and Jerusalem from generation to generation. Alright? So we shall rise again, man. And we're going to rule next, man. Hey, your hope is in vain, Russia. And China, and every other fucking nation on earth, we're going to rule next under the righteousness and rule and arm of Yahweh Basham Yahushai. All right? Under King Malak Dawad, man, King David. And Judah shall dwell forever in Jerusalem from generation to generation. For I will cleanse their blood that I have not cleansed, for Yahweh dwelleth in Zion. You guys got anything else?
Wisdom of Solomon. Mm-hmm. Starting chapter verse 1. Mm-hmm. It says, Wisdom of Solomon 5:1. It says, then shall the righteous man stand in great boldness before the face of such have afflicted him and made no account of his labors. When they see it, they shall be troubled with terrible fear, mm-hmm. and shall be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation.
And that's how the elect is going to receive salvation, is through those chariots. Man, they get beamed up into them. You know, just like how you see in alien movies, and they make it look so scary, man. Getting abducted by aliens.
Right, that's why they do that. You know, they demonize it.
Yeah.
It's always it's contrary.
You know, so that's our salvation, man. Out of what? This destruction that's coming. Out of the nuclear missile, nuclear fire. Go ahead, Rome.
It says, and shall be amazed at the strangeness of his salvation, mm-hmm. so far beyond all they looked for.
Right. You know, because Yahweh Shem and Sharatas are we hoping to be seeing this vision that John is seeing in Revelation 15, verse 2. It says, and I saw, as it were, a sea of glass mingled with fire. And them that had gotten a victory over the beast, and over his image, and over his mark, and over the number of his name stand on the sea of glass, having the harps of the Most High, man. So that's John seeing the vision of the elect in the chariots, man, looking down at this place burning. You know? Yeah. You grab Psalm 91. You got a scripture in Isaiah where it says, I think it's in Isaiah. It's in the prophets. It speaks about hiding in your windows. Something to that effect.
Okay.
If I'm quoting it right. Yeah, you started at one.
This is Psalm 91 and 1. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Mm-hmm.
I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge.
Which is just truth, man. You know, this word.
I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my power, and Him will I trust. It says, surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler.
Mm-hmm. Out of Esau's traps, man. How? Through this wisdom. First and foremost, you know, and Lord willing, through the chariots. Go ahead.
And from the noisome pestilence.
And that noisome pestilence, that nuclear destruction.
Uh-huh. He shall cover thee with his feathers, mm-hmm. and under his wings shall thou trust. His trust shall be thy shield and buckler.
Right, we're just talking about getting beamed up, man. Go ahead.
Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day.
Right, you know. That nuclear missile that's going to get shot.
Nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness.
Mm-hmm.
Nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday.
Right, the Lord said He created the waster to destroy, man.
It says, mm-hmm. 1,000 shall fall at thy side,
mm-hmm.
and 10,000 at thy right.
Mm-hmm. The slain of the Lord shall be from one end of the earth to another, man. Go ahead.
But it shall not come nigh thee.
But it ain't coming near you, man. You know?
It says, only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked.
And a lot of John see it. Only with his eyes he saw the reward of the wicked, man. And he was seeing the elect. He's seeing those that had the victory over the beast in his image. The image is the way of life, man, that this devil promotes. You know? The mark is the chip.
It says, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation.
Mm-hmm. So you made the Lord your dwelling place, man. Why is that in these scriptures, man? You know? Constantly praying and fasting. Asking for forgiveness. Asking to be increased in, you know, in wisdom. In patience. You know, in meekness. You know?
It says, there shall no evil befall thee. Neither shall any plagues come nigh thy dwelling.
Mm-hmm. The Lord said the plagues are sent. So just like in Egypt when He sent the plagues, did any of the plagues affect us when we was in Egypt? Our cattle didn't die when all their cattle died. Our crops didn't get destroyed when all theirs did. Our firstborns didn't die when all theirs did, man. When they had the 3 days of darkness, we had light. You know? So the Lord... The second Egypt, man, the Lord gonna do the same thing, man.
It says, for He shall give His angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. For it's like they shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone.
Right.
Anything else? No,
that's it. Alright,
with
that, all praise, honor,
and
glory to
Yahweh, Baha'u'llah, Yahusha.
Double honors the apostles. Salutations to your brothers, learning to think sincerity and truth, then with charity. Shalom.
Shalom. Shalom.